Hello, I am Professor Dr. Deepika Srivastava from the English department. Today's lecture is meant for BA 6th semester students. The title of my lecture is Godan, the magnum opus of Munshi Premchand. Before I discuss the novel in detail, let me briefly introduce you to Munshi Premchand. He was the most celebrated Hindi novelist of the 20th century. His full name was Dhanpat Rai Srivastava. He was born in 1880 in Lamhi, Banaras, which is now Varanasi. And he died in 1936, again in Varanasi. So his lifespan was merely of 56 years. When Dhanpat Rai Srivastava started his literary career, he wrote under the pseudonym of Nawab Rai. Because he started writing in Urdu, his first short novel was published in a series in a Banaras Urdu weekly, and it was well received. Then he started writing and published his first collection of 5 short stories, again in Urdu. He then started writing in Hindi, and he switched over to the name Munshi Premchand. He published a dozen novels, around 300 short stories, several essays and translations. Amongst his notable works are the one we are going to take up, Godan, Gaban, Karam Bhumi, Shatranj Ke Khiladi and Nirmala. Anyway, we are just going to take up Godan, and so we will discuss Godan for the time being. Premchand married twice. He had very strained relations with his first wife, and she used to often quarrel with his stepmother. So she left the marital home and returned to her father's house. Premchand never bothered to call her back. And he married in 1906 a child widow. This was unheard of in the conservative society of that time. But he broke away from societal norms, and in many of his novels, he also shows widow remarriage, and he takes up other important issues which were affecting the society, especially of northern India village folks. The most remarkable part of his was that he was efficient in Urdu as well as in Hindi. And if I may say so, he had a long association with Allahabad, now Prayagraj, the place where I was born and brought up. Let us now discuss Godan. It means the gift of a cow. Go means cow, and Dan means the gift. And the story revolves around the lives of a very poor peasant by the name of Hori and his family, comprising of his wife and 3 children. This novel was published in 1936, and it is the most celebrated Hindi novels of modern Indian literature. Its theme is socio-economic deprivation and exploitation of the village folks in a village of northern India. This was translated from Hindi to English by Jayaratnam in 1957, and later it was translated again by Gordon C. Rodarmil. It was also made into a Hindi film in 1963 starring Rajkumar, Shashikala and Mehmood. Let us briefly take up the plot of Godaan. The story has many characters representing various sections of the Indian community. The rural society is represented by Hori, who is a very poor farmer, as already mentioned. His wife is Dhania, and his two daughters are Rupa and Sona. The son's name is Gobar, and later the daughter-in-law who comes in the family is Junia. The story starts from a point where Hori has a deep desire to purchase a cow like millions of other poor people from villages. He purchases a cow by taking a debt of 80 rupees from Bhola, a cow herd. Hori then tries to cheat his brothers for a small sum of 10 rupees. This led to a fight between his wife and his younger brother Hira's wife, a family feud. Jealous of Hori, Hira, his younger brother, poisoned the cow and then ran away, fearing police action against him. Ultimately, the matter was reported to the police and they came bombarding into the house of Hori and his brother Hira. Now, to save the family's prestige, Hori took a loan and paid some bribe to the police officers to clear off his younger brother's name. Instead of being happy that the matter settled, the panchayat imposed a fine on him for killing a cow, which in any case Hori had not done. In the meantime, Junia, who is the daughter of this cow herd, Bhola, and also a young widow, she elopes with Gobar, who is Hori's son, and they have a living relationship, and Gobar makes her pregnant. After this act, Gobar is so scared that he runs away from the village and he leaves her behind. Now, this girl, she has nowhere to go, and so she sits at the doorsteps of her in-laws, that is Hori and his wife, and these simple folks, they are unable to throw away a girl carrying the child of their son, and so in their innocence and in their generosity, they accepted her as their daughter-in-law. After a few months, a son was born, and they lavished all their love on this little boy. Again, the village panchayat sits and decides to fine Hori for this act of his son Gobar. This is the second time the poor farmer is put to shame and has to pay through his knows for no fault of his. His wife tackles the personal attack of the Pandit for sheltering Jhunia. But she is a board lady and she can take up the cause on behalf of Jhunia. Now, all the time, Hori has to take loans from people who then take their pound of flesh, and ultimately he succumbs to this pressure. So this is the story of Godan. Anyway, Hori has also taken a huge debt from local money lenders, and to pay them off, he is forced to marry off his daughter Rupa for a mere measly sum of 200 rupees to save his ancestral land from being auctioned. And again, he is going down in debts and he has no funds in the house to pay these land taxes or the debts he has taken from various money lenders. But still, he is firm in his determination to pay the 200 rupees he has paid to buy a cow to provide milk to his grandson. And this leads to his working all the time in the fields. This overwork is nearly killing him. When he is dying, his wife Dhania, who is a strong lady, takes out all the money she had, which is just mere 1 rupees and 25 paisa, and made Hori pay the priest on behalf of Godan. This is the most important act of the novel Godan, the cow donation, which brings salvation to a dying man. And this was eventually Hori's own dream. And he lived and died to fulfill this dream of performing Godan. Nevertheless, he was unable to pay his son-in-law that meager sum of rupees 200, nor could he buy a cow to provide milk to feed his young grandson. So, to bring the summary to its end, I will say that Hori is projected as a typical poor farmer who is a victim of circumstances, but he is shown as an honest, dutiful farmer who will live and die for his principles and never give in or cow down to the hindrances that he faces in life. That was very briefly the summary of Godan. Before I come to the characters, I will request all of you to read the English translation of Godan, and if possible, to read the Hindi classic, which is absolutely unsurpassable to this day. Now, let me introduce you to the characters. There are two sets of characters, one belonging to the rural class, the simple village folks. Some of them are not so simple amongst the village folks also. And the other category is comprising of the urban people, the sophisticated class, the educated class. So there are two sets of characters. One is the village folk, which comprises of Hori, his wife, his son, his daughters, his daughter-in-law, Mata Deen, and Bhola, and so on and so forth. Datta Deen also is here. Mata Deen and Datta Deen. And Selvia is a low caste daughter of a cobbler. Now, I will very briefly tell you about the characters. First, let us take Hori, who is the central character, the protagonist of Godaan. He is a farmer and he is a very hardworking and very upright farmer who lives and dies for carrying the tradition of the village folks and not compromising on his values. He is married to an equally powerful woman, though she is illiterate, yet she is convinced about her principles and will go to any extent to follow them. This is Dhaniya, the able wife of Hori. They have a son who is called Gobar and two daughters. I told you about them, Rupa and Sona. Now, he has two younger brothers also, and he considers his duty to save them from problems. This was an ancient tradition which was followed in the epics also, like Ramayana. Ram, the eldest brother, looked after Lakshman, Bharat and Shatrughan. Similarly, Hori, though he is nothing in comparison to the god Lord Ram, yet he follows this tradition of considering it his duty to save his brothers from all problems that they are facing. And in the process, he sacrifices his own family, and especially he beats his wife many a times to help his two brothers. He bribes the police also, who come inquiring about the death of his cow. He had borrowed money to buy this cow, and his brother Hira, he poisons this cow, and yet this poor Hori, he bribes the police to save the name of the family. He is uselessly penalized for the death of the cow by the panchayat, and he accepts it in all humility. When Gobar brings home a low caste girl, he and his wife accept again this girl without bothering about what the society will say. And when the penalty is levied by the panchayat a second time for bringing a low caste girl in the family, he pays without blinking his eyelashes. Similarly, he allows Bhola, the cowherd, to take his ox away. As he is neither able to pay its cost, and nor is he willing to send away Jhunia, who is incidentally the daughter of this cowherd. Now look at the irony. The cowherd is insisting that Hori turns away his own daughter from his home, and he knows very well that she is carrying the child also of this family. Yet this cowherd is saying that either you push her away or you pay me. Now neither is he willing to push away, nor does he have the money to pay. So this cowherd, he takes his ox, and now he is reduced to being an ordinary farm laborer. Not only he helps the daughter-in-law, he also gives shelter to Selvia, who is the daughter of a poor cobbler, and who is exploited by Mata Deen, an upper caste Brahmin of the village. Let us now come to Dhaniya. She is the devoted wife of Hori, as I told you. She is bold and she will not tolerate any injustice. And on many occasions, she irritates Hori, who beats her for disobeying him, though he knows that she is correct. She stands by her dharma, and she accepts a low caste lady as her daughter-in-law, which many Indians from Hindu families will not do even to this day. She is a kind and a loving mother who makes sacrifices for her children. She also shelters a pregnant Celia, the cobbler's daughter. She does not believe in the caste system. Let us come to Gobar, who is the son of Hori and Dhanya, who is born in this poor family, but he aspires for the comforts of life. Who wants to lead a life of penury? So he leaves the village and he shifts to Lucknow. Here he becomes practical and wise. But the only thing before leaving the village was that he had a partner and she became pregnant, and he leaves this wife of his. This was a very unthoughtful act of his. Anyway, he works for Mirza in Lucknow and he gradually starts his business. In one of his visits to his village, he is dressed up like a gentleman and he tempts youngsters to follow him to the city. He finds that people are exploiting his father, so he returns to the city with his wife Junia. He has in the meantime become an alcoholic and he is known for his short temper. So he has strained relations with Junia, but she nurses him in his sickness, and so the couple, they make up all their differences. He works in a sugar factory and he later becomes a chowkidar in Miss Malti's house. Next we come to Datta Deen. He is the village Brahmin priest, and not only that, he is a greedy money lender. He penalizes Hori for sheltering Junia. Surprisingly, his son, the next character, Mata Deen, he is having an affair with Celia, who works on the farm for him. Her relatives think that Mata Deen is going to marry this girl, but he doesn't. So they decide to punish him by forcibly placing a piece of bone in his mouth. This was unthinkable for Brahmins to do. It was a taboo. And when he is beaten by his own clan, Celia helps him. So Mata Deen becomes an outcast in his own community. His father, he performs the ritual of cleansing him, and in the meantime Mata Deen realizes his mistake in exploiting a girl who trusted him solely. So when he gets to know that she has a son also from this affair, he removes his genoi, the threat that Brahmins wear, and accept Celia as his wife. We come to the next character, who is not very important. He is a minor character in the novel Bhola. He is a cowherd and he is having this young widowed daughter Junia, who ultimately becomes the daughter-in-law of the protagonist Hori. This man is upset when she elopes with Gobar, and look at his audacity. He comes to Hori's house claiming money for the dead cow, whom in any case Hori had not killed. Since Hori is unable to pay, he asks Hori to send his own daughter away from the house. When Hori refuses, he forcibly takes Hori's oxen and thus shows his, you can say, very small mentality. Now we come to the last character amongst the village folk, and this is Chunia. She is, as I told you, not very important, but the only thing is that she manages to be accepted as the daughter-in-law of Gobar family. Now when we have discussed the rural folks, we will come to the urban society, and this I will take up in my part 2 lecture based on this novel, Godha. Thank you.